Did you ever have to think about which competition you had to go into or which school you had to be enrolled into based on the color of your skin? Now, I don't think so. But back then, life was tough. So many things were based on the color of your skin. Black and white were not the bestest friends.
For Black History Month, I researched Charles Drew, a pioneer of a doctor. He fought for equality in medicine. He worked hard to make sure Black people could give blood and be treated equally.
In 1940, he became the director of the Blood for Britain project, which would ship blood and plasma to help treat the civilians and soldiers of World War.
His innovations can be found in hospitals around the world today.
Valia Thomas was born in 1943 and attended the school Morgan State University. Valerie worked on a satellite called Landsat. Landsat would be the first ever satellite to take pictures from space.
Lonnie Johnson is a famous inventor / mathematician.
He had over 120 patents.
We should also say that he invented the super soaker and is currently working on an engine that converts heat into electricity. Now that is amazing.
He served as an engineer for the USA Air Force, where he worked on developing a stealth bomber.
And is known for creating two popular kids' toys.
I chose to talk about John Urschel for Black History Month. He was born in Manitoba, Canada, and he's a mathematician. And a fun fact about him is that in 2014, he was a NFL draft for the Baltimore Ravens.
Daniel Hale Williams was an incredibly talented cardiologist. He was the first cardiologist to successfully perform a repair on the pericardium.
Founded the first Black-owned hospital.
In 1889, he was appointed to the state's Board of Health.
And he opened the first Provident Hospital and Training School for nurses.
Dr. Ayanna Howard is a Black female robot engineer. She designs her robots based off real-life models. She has contributed greatly to the fields of artificial intelligence, computer vision, and robotics.
Emmett Chappell, who is an African-American biochemist, he was born in 1925, and he made serious contributions in science in discovering bioluminescence and using that for scientific applications, as well as researching cellular processes.
I studied Mae Jemison, the first Black woman to go to space.
When she served as a mission specialist aboard the space shuttle Endeavour.
And on her voyage, she brought some artifacts on board that symbolized figures in African-American history.
Although she started out as a biomedical engineer, she had wanted to go to space since she was a child.
As a girl, she studied all the Apollo missions, like what their purposes were and what missions were taking place when.
Mark Dean is a famous computer scientist and engineer. And the main reason I chose him was because of his contribution, being that he took computers and made them more accessible and powerful.
Hi, this is the life of Dr. Betty Wright. She was a chemist born in July 1940, and she was raised in Louisiana with 12 siblings. She is best known for the invention of the T2B aromatic explosive test bot, which is used in military institutions to this day.
Edward Bouchet. He was a physicist, and he's pretty much best known for becoming the first African-American to earn the doctoral degree in the United States in 1876.
James E. West.
He's a professor in electrical and computer engineering and mechanical engineering at Johns Hopkins University.
He was the co-inventor of the foil elect microphone, which is the most commonly used microphone today.
His family and friends described him as always working and would constantly try to help people out.
Benjamin Banneker lived from 1731 to 1806, and he was a very early Black mathematician, astronomer, farmer, and surveyor in the times of the American colonies.
Percy Julian, who was a black chemist. What he endured a lot of racism, so he researched a lot of stuff in chemistry that we didn't know about today and helped add to a lot of the stuff that we do know today. He helped fight for other African Americans to become chemists.
And I was researching Dr. Gladys West. She helped design the CSAT project, which was the backbone of the modern-day GPS.
Chemist Alice Augusta Ball developed a successful treatment for Hansen's disease, also known as leprosy.
Today I'm going to be talking about Dr. Rebecca Lee Crumpler.
Dr. Crumpler was born in Delaware and was the first African-American woman to get a medical degree.
In her childhood, her aunt started to get very sick, so this helped her realize that she had a big passion of helping others.
In 1866, she moved to Richmond, Virginia, and gave medical care to freed slaves.
Rebecca Lee Crumpler wrote one of the country's early medical textbooks, The Guide for Women and Children, entitled The Book of Medical Discourses.
They all were united to get one thing, equality. And that's why we celebrate Black History Month now.